Hello children, we are in a chapter called Magnetic Effect of Electric Current, one of the wonderful chapter in physics and very useful informative chapter. And with respect to the examination point of view, it is a very important chapter for scoring marks. The first thing is what you have to understand in this lesson is Magnetic Effect of Electric Current was discovered by a scientist by name Oersted. What is magnetic effect of electric current? A conductor carrying electric current produces magnetic field around it. What is magnetic field? Magnetic field is a region around a magnet in which magnetic force can be detected. Magnetic field comprises of what? Magnetic field comprises of magnetic field lines. What are the properties of magnetic field lines? Magnetic field lines are vector quantities. They have both magnitude and direction. Magnetic field lines are closed curves. Magnetic field lines are always directed from north to south outside the magnet and south to north inside the magnet. There is no chance that two magnetic field lines are going to intersect. Like poles repel each other and like poles attract each other. The next is how to draw a diagram of magnetic field lines around a bar magnet. That you have to practice. There is a diagram how the magnetic field lines around a bar magnet. The next question arises, if a conductor carrying electric current produces magnetic field, is that magnetic field same as the magnetic field of the bar magnet? No. The magnetic field produced by a conductor carrying electric current is in the form of concentric circles. The next question arises, how to identify the direction of the magnetic field lines in the case of a straight conductor carrying electric current with the help of a rule called right hand thumb rule. What is this right hand thumb rule? Imagine that we are holding a conductor carrying electric current by our right hand. Thumb indicates the direction of the electric current and fingers wrap in the direction of the magnetic field lines. Therefore, we can easily identify the direction of the magnetic field lines around the conductor carrying electric current. The next question arises, if we allow the electric current to pass through a circular loop, what is the difference we are going to get? We are going to get a very strong magnetic field at the center of the circular loop, and the magnetic field obtained, the magnetic field lines are parallel in nature, therefore it is called the uniform magnetic field. Now we have three different types of magnetic field. One is magnetic field around a bar magnet, magnetic field around a straight conductor carrying electric current, magnetic field at the center of the circular loop, and how to write the magnetic field lines. If magnetic field lines are parallel in nature, we call that magnetic field as uniform magnetic field. Where we are using this knowledge of magnetic field? The knowledge of magnetic field is used for making certain devices. The first device is a solenoid. What is a solenoid? Solenoid is nothing but a coil made up of the insulated copper wire, n number of insulated copper wire, wrapped closely in the shape of a cylinder. When a solenoid is connected to a source of DC source, it produces magnetic field. How the magnetic field looks? That you should know how to draw the diagram of magnetic field around a solenoid. In the case of a solenoid, the magnetic field looks like a magnetic field of a bar magnet outside the solenoid, but inside the solenoid, the magnetic field lines are parallel in nature. For what purpose solenoids are used? Solenoids are used for making very powerful electromagnets. Then, among permanent magnet and electromagnet, which one is stronger? Electromagnets are stronger. And we can increase the strength of the magnetic field produced by an electromagnet by increasing the current or by increasing the number of turns of the solenoid. Next is Henri Ampère, a scientist, performed an experiment. In that experiment, he showed that when a conductor carrying electric current is kept inside the magnetic field, it experiences a force. And by that force, the conductor tilts. And the tilt of the conductor is utilized to make a device called motor. And he is able to understand there is a direct relationship between the direction of the magnetic field, direction of the electric current and the motion of the conductor in that experiment, and that was explained by stretch thumb, forefinger, middle finger of the left hand mutually perpendicular to each other. Thumb indicates the direction of the motion of the conductor, forefinger indicates the direction of the magnetic field, and middle finger indicates the direction of the electric current. Using this knowledge, we are able to understand another device called the motor. Very useful content for the public examination. Motor, electric motor or DC motor. What is motor? Motor is a device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. There are two different types of motor, AC motor, DC motor. DC motor is a simple electric motor, whereas AC motor is a commercial motor. Motor works on the principle of the force experienced by a conductor carrying electric current kept inside the magnetic field. The working of a motor is explained by the Fleming's left hand rule. Then, which are the parts of the motor? Motor comprises of a rectangular coil of very fine insulated copper wire. Coil is connected to what? Coil is connected to two copper split rings. Then what is armature of the motor? Armature means coil and split rings together called armature. Where the coil is situated? Coil is situated between the poles of a powerful magnet. Where the split rings are connected? Split rings are made to attach to two carbon brushes. Carbon means graphite. Graphite and carbon brushes are connected to a DC source. And we can explain the working of a motor with the help of a Fleming's left hand rule. There, the direction of the electric current changes in every half rotation in the case of a coil, and the change of the direction of the electric current is done with the help of a part of the DC motor called commutator. Which part is called the commutator? Split ring is called the commutator. Next, is there any difference between a simple electric motor and a commercial motor? Yes. The commercial motors, they use electromagnets. Second one, in commercial motor, the number of turns in the coil, the number of turns of the insulated copper wire in the coil is more in number. And in commercial motors, we use soft iron core to get a very strong magnetic field. And these are the differences between the commercial motor and a simple motor. This much I completed in the previous class. You have to repeat. Every time you have to repeat. And this is a very informative chapter. Now I am going to explain the contribution of a very, very important scientist, and the name of the scientist is Michael Faraday is a very important scientist, and he discovered something breakthrough. See, and his life is a motivation for many youngsters. Many people got motivated by the life history of Michael Faraday. And this Michael Faraday discovered electromagnetic induction. Today's class, we are going to learn about what is electromagnetic induction and what is the contribution of Michael Faraday to the field of science. And he is a great human being. Michael Faraday lived in a very poorest of the poor family. There is no basic education. He is not gone to any school and colleges because of the poverty, and he is not had a proper meat to eat. But Michael Faraday discovered many things, and now all over the world, all the schools and colleges, they study the contribution of Michael Faraday. That is the greatness of that man. That is the greatness of the life of Michael Faraday. As young students, you have to always read books related to the life history of these type of people. This type of life histories, autobiographies, definitely motivates our life. But I don't want to tell about the story related to Michael Faraday, what is his life, how he came across this concept and how he made, because we are talking about the science part, and it is your duty to understand the contribution of Michael Faraday and his life history, right? And today's class, I am going to tell about a concept called electromagnetic induction, and this was discovered by Michael Faraday in 1813. Now, first thing is, what is this electromagnetic induction? How he was discovered? That we have to understand. Electromagnetic induction. You see the word electromagnetic induction. Electromagnetic induction. You have heard of the concept called induction stove, induction cooker. Induction means transfer of energy without the physical contact of the materials. See, whenever we have to transfer energy from one body to another body, there should be a physical contact of the bodies. In such cases, we call them as conduction. The energy, for example, when two hot bodies are kept touching each other, there are two hot bodies. When two hot bodies are kept touching each other, for example, this particular body is having a temperature of 30 degrees and this body is having a temperature of 20 degrees. Since this body is having more temperature, obviously heat energy transfer from this body to that body. The transfer of energy from one body to another body with the physical contact is called the conduction. Suppose if you wanted to transfer energy from one body to another body, as in the case of a transformer, the electricity is in the primary coil and there is a secondary coil. There is no contact between these two coils, but electricity from one coil is going to transfer to another coil. There is no physical contact here. In such cases, we call it as induction. Induction means transfer of energy from one body to another body without the physical contact is called the induction. If there is a physical contact, we call it as a conduction. Today's class, we are going to learn about electromagnetic induction. This was discovered by Michael Faraday. Michael Faraday, what he did is, I already told you, his life history is definitely going to motivate many people. And this is not a class to tell the life history of a scientist. But personally, what I feel is, you should know the life history of Michael Faraday, because definitely I tell you, it motivates you. Why? Because that hard life, hard, very difficult life we come across, even then he is able to do all these things. Means the God has given everything to us. We are very fortunate to have a wonderful parents, wonderful environment, wonderful school. Everything is nice in our life. But why we are not able to do that? We have to think. We have to think the life history of such people, and by that we can get motivated and we also can able to do wonderful things in the life. See here, Michael Faraday, he performed an experiment to discover electromagnetic induction. What experiment he did? He took a cardboard cylinder. See, I also taken a cylinder. It is made up of plastic. A cylinder, it is made up of plastic. He took what is known as the cardboard cylinder. Cardboard and plastic, what is the relation? Both are bad conductor of electricity. And here there is a cardboard cylinder. On the cardboard cylinder, I am able to get number of turns of the insulated copper wire. The copper wire is wound around this particular cardboard cylinder or a plastic cylinder to make a coil. The structure what you are seeing at present is called a coil. And this coil is made up of, according to Michael Faraday's experiment, it is made up of a cardboard cylinder and insulated copper wire. This white thing is called the insulation. And this is the copper wire. Copper wire is insulated. Insulated. I remove the insulation, right? It is an insulated copper wire. It is, we can see the number of turns of insulated copper wire on this particular cylinder, and this particular part is called the coil. And now I write the diagram of this coil. How to write the diagram of the coil? First I write the cardboard cylinder or the plastic cylinder. It is just like this. See, this is a cylinder. See, writing diagram is just again. It is a skill part. An intelligent student always write diagram very nicely. Why? Because the writing diagram is a skill level. Skill level. Haphazardly, with a little laziness, we should not write the diagram. Diagram should be neatly outlined. See, now what I am doing is, this represents the terms of the insulated copper wire. On the cardboard cylinder, this type of insulated copper wire are wrapping. See. insulated copper wire. You also write diagram neatly. You also write along with me. Today we are going to learn the contribution of a very great man by name Michael Faraday. See, this is the coil. When you make a coil, definitely you should get the end wire. We call them as terminals. These are called the terminals. See, terminals. This is coil. Michael Faraday, this is what I repeat as again. Don't forget the name of this particular scientist. Michael Faraday discovered electromagnetic induction. Who discovered electromagnetic induction? Michael Faraday. What is the contribution of Michael Faraday to the field of physics? He discovered electromagnetic induction. Right? He discovered electromagnetic induction by performing an experiment. For the experiment, he made a coil. Coil is made with the help of a cardboard cylinder and insulated copper. And then, he took an instrument, he took a device. This device is called galvanometer. This device is called what? Galvanometer. See the galvanometer. This is the pointer of the galvanometer. You can see, easily see the pointer of the galvanometer, right? Here there is a pointer of the galvanometer. It tilts. It shows how much of current is going to come. Galvanometer is an instrument that you have to understand here. See, I write it here. Regarding electricity, we have an instrument called, device called ammeter. Ammeter is a device which is used to measure electric current. If electric current is there, to measure electric current, we use a device called ammeter. This is called ammeter. This is called galvanometer. Galvanometer. This is an instrument which is used to detect electric current. See, detect electric current is different from measuring electric current. To measure electric current, they require ammeter. To detect electric current, we have to use a device called galvanometer. Here, Michael Faraday is discovering a concept called electromagnetic induction. Here, you have to understand what made him to do this experiment. What made him to do this experiment is, again, I'll tell you here. See, Michael Faraday, you have to understand incident of his life that made him to discover this. Michael Faraday was working in a bookbinding shop. In small age, he was working and eating. He never depended on anybody else. He's self-made man. He was working in the school, he's a very younger age, in a bookbinding shop. And he was very much interested in science subjects. Whenever he gets to read a science book, he started reading that book. One day, he read a book written by another scientist by name, we know the name of that scientist, that is Einstein. Einstein discovered what? Einstein discovered magnetic effect of electric current. In the book this Michael Faraday was using to read, in that book, the Einstein experiment was mentioned. According to the Einstein experiment, a current carrying conductor produces magnetic field around it. See here. We all know that. A current carrying conductor produces what? Magnetic field around it. And we know how to write the direction of the magnetic field, which is using right hand compass. Michael Faraday saw this magnet. He was very young at the time. Very young, maybe 7 to 10 years of age. He saw this diagram. A conductor carrying electric current produces magnetic field. The young brain got an idea. If electric current was discovered, and we are able to produce electric current with the help of cells. We, in your higher classes, you are going to learn about the chemical cells, chemical Daniell cell, Leclanché cells. You are going to learn in your higher classes. Their chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. But that electrical energy was, at that time was able to develop, was very small quantity, like a cells, like Leclanché cells, like that type of cells, they are able to do.
And Einstein told a conductor carrying electric current produces magnetic field along them. Therefore, seeing this diagram, the young brain of Michael Faraday thought a new thing to this. If a conductor carrying electric current produces magnetic field, why we can't generate electricity with the help of a magnetic field? Converse. If current can produce magnetic field, why magnetic field cannot produce current? That idea is always he had in his brain. Who? Michael Faraday. And to quench his interest or understand, current produces magnetic field, why the magnetic field cannot produce current? To satisfy his interest, he performed this experiment. In this experiment, he made a coil. This coil is having made by a cardboard cylinder with a number of turns of the insulated copper wire. And to understand, is current is there or not? If current coming, then we have to detect the current. To detect the current, we require an instrument called what? Galvanometer. What he did is, he took the galvanometer. He was working in a lab of another scientist by name Humphrey Davy. In that lab, he collected the galvanometer and he connected to the terminals. See how to connect, I show you. This is the end point. Here, the smaller holes are there. You have to take and you have to touch it like this. So, over. This is over. Now, I take this one. The hole is here. I put it on the hole. See, I turn. Now, the coil is connected to a galvanometer. The purpose of using galvanometer, if any current comes in this coil, it is detected by the galvanometer. That is the idea of Michael Faraday. Now, what he did is, he connect this coil, what he did, he connect the terminals means end points of the coil, to an instrument called galvanometer. And I told you what is galvanometer. Galvanometer is a device which is used to detect electric current. This is the coil and this is the galvanometer, right? Like this. I kept it vertical portion, but the diagram is in the horizontal portion, right? Then, he took a magnet. And he simply kept inside the coil, inside the cylinder, see like this. Nothing happened. There is galvanometer is not showing anything. But now you see. Now you see the pointer of the galvanometer. When I move this magnet, you have to see the pointer. You can see the tilt of the pointer. Pointer is slightly tilting. Why it is tilting? When the magnet is moving like this, the pointer of the galvanometer is tilting. The tilting is because of the presence of the electric current that is produced in the conductor. Since there is no contact between the magnet and the coil, he called this as induction. You can able to see, I think so, right? When I move the magnet inside the coil like this, you can see the pointer of the galvanometer started deflecting. Deflecting means deflection, it bends like this. That shows the current is produced and started flowing in this particular coil, and we generated electric current with the help of a magnet. There is nothing, no source. There is no battery, battery cell, nothing is there. I am able to generate electric current with the help of a magnet. But when I keep the magnet simply like this, you don't see any deflection of the galvanometer. But when I start moving it, the point of the galvanometer started deflecting. Therefore, he understood that keep the coil stationary and make the magnet to move inside the coil, current is induced. Understood? Here, coil is stationary, magnet is in motion, we can able to see
the induced current in the with the help of the galvanometer. Therefore, what you see in the diagram, when you write in the diagram, you have to write like this. This is the coil, I write this as a coil, and this is the galvanometer. When I take a magnet, the magnet is having north and south pole. Simply keeping like this, no current is there. You have to make the magnet to move inside the coil and remove. Therefore, this arrow mark is very much important to understand the concept of electromagnetic induction. This is called the electromagnetic. What it is, see, very simple. What is electromagnetic? Who discovered electromagnetic induction? Michael Faraday discovered electromagnetic. What is electromagnetic induction means? See this. This is what is this? This is a magnet. The magnet is surrounded by magnetic field. Is magnetic field is visible? No, magnetic field is not visible. When I make the magnet move like this, the magnetic field is changing along with the magnet. The magnet is changing the position, right? Along with the change of the position of the magnetic field also changes. But the change of the magnetic field is not linking to the coil. Now what I make is, I make the magnetic field to change with respect to this conductor. Therefore, a changing magnetic field linking a conductor. Try to understand. If you keep magnet here and coil here, and if you do like this, you don't get current. This magnetic field has to change when it is linking to the conductor. Then electric current induces in the conductor, and this statement is the statement of electromagnetic induction. Then what is electromagnetic induction mean? I write it here. A changing magnetic field. I write MF because there is no space. MF stands for magnetic field. A changing magnetic field linking a conductor induces, I don't write produces because there is no contact there, induces what? Electric current where? In the conductor. Electric current in the conductor, and the produced or induced electric current is identified, detected by an instrument called galvanometer. Now I again repeat the experiment conducted by Michael Faraday and explain the definition of electromagnetic induction. The first thing is, we start with the beginning. Who discovered electromagnetic induction? Michael Faraday. Michael Faraday, scientist, discovered electromagnetic induction. What is electromagnetic induction? A changing magnetic field linking a conductor induces electric current in the conductor. This phenomenon is called electromagnetic induction. Now, all over the world, all transformers work on the principle of electromagnetic induction even now. And all over the world, whichever country it may be, in all countries, electricity is generated, and electricity is generated by a device called generator. And all generator works on the principle of this only. That is the greatness of Michael Faraday. See, Michael Faraday, he may not be gone to the school, he is not attended any, he not had any degree, nothing. But today, if you wanted to learn, you want light. If you wanted light, you want electricity. That electricity is generated by the idea that was developed by Michael Faraday. All over the world, electricity is generated even now by the same technique that was shown by Michael Faraday. Right? And that concept is called electromagnetic induction. What is that? What is electromagnetic induction? A changing magnetic field linking a conductor induces electric current in the conductor. Then how he discovered? He performed an experiment. In that experiment, he made a coil. He made a coil with the help of a cardboard cylinder
an insulated copper wire. He connected that terminals of the coil to a device called galvanometer.
What is galvanometer? Galvanometer is a device which is used to detect electric current.
And he took a powerful magnet. When he inserted the magnet into the coil, the point of the galvanometer reflect to show the presence of electric current. Then by that he mentioned that when the coil is stationary, magnet should be in motion to get induced current. When coil is stationary,
we have to make the magnet to move inside the coil to get what? Electric current. Now the question is, coil is stationary, magnet should be in motion. Now my question is, can we induce electric current by keeping the magnet stationary? I don't want to move the magnet. Can I induce electric current? Yes, I can induce electric current. By keeping the magnet stationary, move the coil like this. Therefore, a stationary magnet can able to induce electric current in the moving coil. Moving. When the coil is stationary, magnet should be in motion. When the magnet is stationary, coil should be in motion. Suppose both are stationary, there is no induced current. Or both are in motion like this. When both are in motion in the same direction, there is no induced current. But we can induce electric current when both are moving in the opposite direction. This type we can able to induce. But you have to remember four conditions. What is that? The conditions of electromagnetic induction is like this. When magnet is stationary, coil should be in motion. When coil is stationary, magnet should be in motion. If both are stationary, there is no induced current. Both are in motion in the same direction, there is no induced current. Therefore, I write the diagram related to these four conditions. Then you have to identify. This is a wonderful question for a multiple choice in India. See this, I write it here. See? Now I write a coil. Small diagram I write. You have to understand and you are brilliant and write this type of diagram and understand. Once you understand, complete your life, you can able to remember the contribution of Michael Faraday. When you understand the contribution of Michael Faraday, then you get motivation. When you get motivation, you can become successful in your life. Therefore, see, I write one diagram like this, right? Again, I write one more diagram. I have to write four diagrams like this to make you to understand. See, this is another coil. Again, these two are connected to what? These two are connected to a galvanometer. G, and here there is a magnet. Two diagrams are over. Same diagram again I write. One picture is better than 1,000 words. There is a saying in this. Simply learning something, instead of that one, write diagrams and understand things better. Physics can be understood with the help of a diagram. Therefore, in higher classes, we get more diagrammatical representation of the concepts of physics. 1, 2, 3, 3 is written. One more I write. Here I write. I require four things to understand, four diagrams to understand electromagnetic induction in a better manner. Galvanometer and air magnet. Now see, four diagrams are there. Now see, here I write like this. What you understood in this is, coil is stationary, magnet is in motion, therefore we can think that the point of the galvanometer deflects. We can get the induced current. Now here, sir, in the second diagram, here magnet is stationary, coil is in motion, then also I can get induced current. Here, I don't put arrow mark at all.
If I don't put atom on, then what you would say? Both magnet and coil are stationary. Therefore, there is no induced current. Here I write.
Both are in motion. Both are in motion in the same direction.
Both are in motion in
same direction.
There is no induced current here. There is an induced current here. There is induced current here. There is no induced current here. There is no induced current here. Therefore, what is this statement? In the Faraday's experiment, when magnet is in motion, coil is in stationary, there is induced current. In Faraday's experiment, when the magnet is stationary, coil should be in motion to get the induced current. If both magnet and coil are stationary, there is no induced current. When both magnet and coil are in motion in the same direction with the same speed, there is no induced current. Therefore, this is the practical inference we get from the experiment conducted by the great mathematician, great scientist by name Michael Faraday. And Michael Faraday discovered a beautiful concept in physics called electromagnetic induction. Who discovered electromagnetic induction? Michael Faraday. What is electromagnetic induction? A changing magnetic field linking a conductor induces electric current in the conductor. To perform the experiment, what all he used? He used a coil. He used a galvanometer. What is galvanometer? Galvanometer is a device which is used to detect electric current. And he selected a powerful magnet. Right? And the conditions required are, when the magnet is in motion, coil should be stationary. When coil is in motion, magnet should be stationary. If both are stationary, there is no induced current. When both are in motion in the same direction also, there is no induced current. If you see this diagram, you can also able to understand there is three things are in motion now. Three things are in motion. One is the coil. I call this coil as a conductor. It is a conductor. This one is magnet. And here what we are getting? Current. Therefore, in this experiment, there is a relationship between three things. One is motion of the conductor, direction of the magnetic field, direction of the electric current. Three things are there. Using these three things, which are three things? Direction of the magnetic field, direction of the electric current, and direction of the conductor. Using these three things, a scientist by name John Ambrose Fleming, he formulated another hand rule. You are already familiar with the Fleming's left hand rule. Now I am going to introduce Fleming's right hand rule. The right hand rule explains the relationship between the motion of the conductor, magnetic field and electric current in the case of electromagnetic induction. Which are the three things? Three things are, first one is, now I am going to write Fleming's. See, if you are interested in science, we have two things in 10th standard. One is Fleming's left hand rule. It helps us to understand the working of a motor. Now Fleming's right hand rule. See, now try to understand. Therefore, definitely in the public examination, either of the left hand rule or right hand rule, definitely there in the public examination. Right hand rule. Fleming's right hand rule. Now I am going to state the Fleming's right hand rule. It is related to electromagnetic induction. What it tells, there are three relations. One is the directions of, I write here, directions of motion of the conductor. Motion of the conductor. Second one is direction of the magnetic field. You have to read along with this. Direction of the magnetic field. Third one, direction of the electric current. Since electric current is induced here, I introduce the word induced current. Induced electric current also. Now, the Fleming's right hand rule, the same thing it is. There is no difference between the Fleming's right hand rule and left hand rule. Here, this is left hand, this is right. I repeat the left hand first. This is already, I explained in, while explaining the motor, working of a motor. What the Fleming's left hand rule told? Stretch thumb, forefinger, middle finger of the left hand. If you wanted to understand the right hand rule, same thing, stretch thumb, forefinger, middle finger of the right hand to mutually perpendicular to each other. Every finger should be right angles to each other. Right? In the left hand rule, what I told, forefinger indicates, forefinger means finger, forefinger F indicates the direction of the magnetic field, right? Forefinger indicates the direction of the magnetic field, field F, magnetic field F, forefinger. Here also, in the right hand rule also, forefinger indicates the direction of the magnetic field, there is no change, right? Here I told middle finger, left hand rule, middle finger indicates the direction of the electric current, I told. Middle finger indicates the direction of the electric current. Here I tell you, middle finger indicates the direction of the induced current. That is the only one difference. And thumb indicates the direction of the motion of the conductor in both the cases. Therefore, it is easy to remember Fleming's left hand rule and right hand rule. Only one difference. In the left hand rule, you have to mention electric current. In the right hand rule, you have to mention induced current. Therefore, the Fleming's right hand rule is like this. Stretch thumb, forefinger, middle finger of the right hand mutually perpendicular to each other. Forefinger indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Forefinger indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Middle finger indicates the direction of the induced current. And thumb indicates the direction of the motion of the conductor. See, now if you read both together, you can easily understand what is the difference between the left hand rule and the right hand rule. The left hand rule, it is electric current. In the right hand rule, it is induced current. Right, the left hand rule is used to explain the working of a motor. The right hand rule is used to explain the working of a generator. Motor, generator. Electric current, induced current. See, now here I write it here. Motion of the conductor is indicated by the thumb. Thumb. Magnetic field is indicated by the forefinger. Forefinger. Induced current, direction of the induced current is indicated by the middle finger. Middle finger. Therefore, it is easy to remember both right hand rule and left hand rule. Right hand rule is related to generator. Left hand rule is related to motor. Therefore, any student can understand. In public examination this year, either you have to get a motor or a generator. If it's motor is there, you have to apply left. If it is generator is there, you have to apply right. In the left, we use electric current. In the right, we use induced current. That is the concept of this particular unit. I repeat. See, today's class, I told you about electromagnetic induction. It was discovered by Michael Faraday. Michael Faraday was motivated by the discovery of oyster. A current-carrying conductor produces magnetic field. Why we can't generate electricity with the help of a magnetic field? That was his doubt and that was his idea. By that he discovered electromagnetic induction. He performed an experiment. In that experiment he used only three things. Coil, galvanometer and the magnet. Galvanometer is the instrument used to detect electric current. When the magnet is moved inside the coil, he is able to see the deflection in the point of the galvanometer. Therefore, he told that electric current is induced. A changing magnetic field linking a conductor induces electric current in the conductor. The condition, four conditions you have to remember. And then, the relation between the directions. The direction of the motion of the conductor, direction of the magnetic field and direction of the induced current is explained with the help of Fleming's right hand rule.